Happy Sunday!
And welcome to
King's Kids in your house.
In your house. It's yeah. So lovely to see you again today. Are you cozy and warm in your home?
We hope you are. We'd love to really be in your house because it's a bit wet and cold out here today. But thankfully, we've got fluffy warm hats.
Yes, we
which
do.
Which are probably made by a sheep.
Let's find out what we're doing today.
Thank you, sheep.
We're going to have free play again with some of our year sixes.
Oh, yeah. Come on, year sixes.
We will sing to our wonderful king because his love is so big.
His love really is so big.
His love is so big.
Amazingly big.
All over the world.
Thankfully, his love is so big that he's given Claire enough to forgive me for accidentally tripping her up last week.
Now, we will be having a big word race to find out another one of the stories we're going to learn about today.
Oh, yeah.
We will have a big story of someone reading it out.
Yeah, our year six is going to read the story, and they're not making it up. It's not a tall story.
No.
It's a real Jesus story.
I hope we're going to see Mr. and Mrs. Jam this week.
Oh, yes, because last week they showed us about how God is like a good shepherd. Now, just as a good shepherd looks after their sheep, and make sure that they don't go missing, and make sure that they have everything that they need. Well, God is like that. He is our good shepherd, looking after us, making sure that we don't go missing. He wants us to be with him,
yes,
so that he can give us all the good things that he has for us.
Now, in my pocket here, I have got out a lovely little sheep that we had delivered by surprise into our back garden. Let me show you.
Yeah, we did wonder whether this little sheep was lost.
But we found him, didn't we?
We found him. Yeah, he got delivered by a sheep ninja.
He did.
Yeah, amazing.
Now, of course, we will have a big game, hopefully with Kitchen Caleb. Kitchen Caleb's so fantastic.
He keeps our kitchen spick and span.
He does.
Thank you, Kitchen Caleb.
And of course, we want to have home challenges because everything we learn and experience of who God is, we don't want it just to be for us. We want to be able to share it with others so
yeah,
they get to know all the great things about God too.
That's right. Yeah, thank you, Lord, that you fill us up with so much goodness, that you give us enough to share with those around us.
Let's see later which 10 children are going to get those jammy dodgers.
Oh yes, it's the big biscuit challenge. Who's it going to be this week? 10
and
lovely
right
children
now,
are going to get some biscuits
out.
Oh yes, let's find out
which year sixes are going to lead with us today.
Yay, these guys.
Hi King's Kids, my name is Anaya.
Hi King's Kids, I'm Samuel.
Hi King's Kids,
my name's Emily,
and it's time to play pairs.
You know how to play.
I'll say a word, then you shout out what you think the word is often paired with.
Here we go.
Fish. Shout out your answer what you think it's paired with.
Shout out your guess now.
And chips. Yes, that's right. Fish and chips are often paired together. Let's do another one. Birds. Shout out your answer what you think it's paired with.
Shout out your guess now.
And bees. That's right, birds and bees are often paired together. Let's do one last final one. Table, shout out your answer.
Shout out your guess now.
And chairs. That's right, tables and chairs are often paired together.
Did you guess them all correctly?
I'm sure you did.
King's Kids, I've got some great news for you. God is here and he can do anything.
That's right, Emily. God can do anything. And he was doing some great things with us all last week. Let's see all the lovely videos you sent in.
Everyone's coming to praise, joining together to honor your name. Jesus is Lord, we will sing over everything. Everyone's coming to praise, showing the world it is Jesus who reigns. He is the light and the way over everything. So lift up your voice to our God, for He reigns. God be glorified. God be glorified.
Oh, why don't we make something together so that we can remember how God is our good shepherd. I've been making a beautiful sheep.
The bread there, it just
sits in
me. Look at me.
Joining together to honor your name. Jesus is Lord, we will sing over everything. Jesus who reigns, He is the light and the way of everything. So lift up your voice to our God, for He reigns. God be glorified.
Game, set, match. You put your potato in one of them and you simply throw it to each other like so. The most important part of the game is that you're counting up, and if you drop it, you have to start again.
Were fantastic. Now let's pray for today's session. I'll say a bit and you say it back. Dear Lord, I pray for today's session. I pray that it all goes well. I thank you for being there when we need it most. Amen.
Thank you, Samuel, for praying for our session today.
Well done, Samuel. It's now time to sing to the three guys who made our noses, who made our toesies, and our thighs.
Let's worship.
Yeah.
Let's sing Great Big God. Right. Yeah, woo! Are you rolling? And he's always by my side. Got a great big God, oh, by my side. Got a great big God, oh, he's always by my side. Got a great big God, oh, by my side.
God is big all over me.
And God is big all over you.
And God is big all over us.
God is big.
God is big all over me. God is big all over you. God is big all over me.
There's love is so small, so small, so small. There's love is so small, so small. There's love is so small. There's love is so small. There's love is so small. My love is great to praise the Lord. No, no, one more. Get really small. Get really small. God's love. God's love is so big. It's so big. It's so big. God's love is so big. It's so big. It's so big. God's love is so big. It's so big. It's so big. God's love is so big. It's so big. I've got a great big girl. And I'm going to have a son.
Man's love is so small, it's so small.
Yeah! God's love is so big, it's so big, it's so big. God's love is so big, it's so big, it's so big. God's love is so big, it's so big, it's so big. God's love is so big, it's so big, it's so big. God's love is so big, it's so big, it's so big. God's love is so big, it's so big, it's so big. God's love is so big, it's so big, it's so big.
God's love is so big.
Water you turned into wine. Open the eyes of the blind. There's no one. Darkness you shine, out of the ashes you rise, there's no one like you, none like you. Our God is greater, our God is stronger, God you are higher than. Awesome in power, our God, our God. Our God is greater, our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power, our God, our God. And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what could stand against it? And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what could stand against? You shine, out of the ashes we rise, there's no one like you,
no. Jesus,
none like you. is healer. Awesome in power, our God. Our God.
Wait on him together for a moment. Let him speak to you. Thank you, Lord. We welcome you, Holy Spirit, to speak to us all. We want to be quiet before you now.
Thank you, Papa.
Thank you, Lord.
That you are the greatest of all.
You are.
There is nobody above you.
No.
There is nothing that you cannot do.
Thank
Everything
you,
is possible for you.
Yeah.
You are our maker.
You are.
You are the one who made us and everything that we can see.
Yeah.
The earth is yours and everything and everyone that is in it. Father, thank you that we can call you Father, that we can call you Papa,
yeah.
That the greatest beings in the whole of everywhere are known to us, and you invite us to know you all the more. We want to know more of your greatness,
yeah,
today, Lord.
Yeah.
More of your power today.
Amen.
Fill us with you, Holy Spirit.
Thank you.
You are powerful.
Thank you, Lord.
You say that you are a spirit of love.
Yeah.
And a spirit of power.
Yeah.
And a spirit who gives us right ways of thinking,
yeah,
and seeing things.
Yeah.
Yes, we want you and all your good ways in us today.
We do.
Because
thank you, Lord.
There is no one like you.
Thank you, Father.
No one in the whole of anywhere is like you.
Yes.
Now it's time to explore who God is. Today we're going to see how God is our rock. Let's have a big word race to find out where Jesus shows us this in the Bible. You have 10 seconds to get your Bible. On your marks, get set, go! 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Got your Bibles? Great. The book we need to find is in the New Testament. Don't forget to shout out hallelujah when you found it. It's in the book of Matthew. Come on, quickly, King's Kids. You can find it. Everybody at home needs to find it. Quickly, Bible hunting. And hallelujah. Now we need to find the chapter, which is the big number. We need to find the big number 7. Come on, quickly, King's Kids. You can find it. Keep looking. It's the big number 7. Hallelujah! It's in Matthew chapter 7, verses 24 to 27, that we see Jesus telling the parable of the two builders. A parable is a story that Jesus told to explain something. Now let's listen to the parable of the two builders.
To help us understand how important it is to listen to God and obey Him, Jesus once told a story about two builders. There was a good builder. He looked for a big rock to build his house on. It was hard work, but he wanted the house to have a strong foundation. The other builder didn't work hard to make his house strong. It was easier to build on sand. He was in a hurry to get finished. A big storm came. It rained and rained. The water got deeper and deeper and crashed against the houses. The water rushed past the house built on the sand. All the sand washed away and that house fell down. But the heavy rain and the rushing water did not move the house on the rock. The builder knew his house was safe. This was a story that Jesus told to teach us something important. Following Jesus is like having a safe rock to trust. Jesus said, "If you hear my words and obey them, it will make you strong. You'll be like a house on a rock. But if you hear my words and don't obey them, it is like building your life on sand."
Cuts Kitchen!
Hi, King's Kid!
Hello, where you can see some of the great, lovely ingredients of who God is, all set behind us here in a lovely, big heart shape.
And they're set in a beautiful heart shape because God's love is the main ingredient that all of God's ingredients are smothered in, King's Kids.
That is right, Strawberry. They are. God's love is in everything that He is, which is so lovely. Oh, God, there's nobody like you. Nobody at all.
No one.
Now, I don't know about you, King's Kids, and you, Strawberry, but I really enjoyed that story that wee Samuel told us.
Oh, yeah.
About these two builders.
Yeah.
Aye. And the thing that we learnt from the story was that God is our rock.
Oi, oi, yeah, we enjoyed it very much too.
And so did we. The first builder chose to build his house on a rock, a solid foundation. It took longer to build, but because it was built on a rock, when the storm came, it was not shaken.
And that other builder, what a cowboy, he built his house on sand. It was quick to build, but because he built his house on sand, when the storm came, his house got washed away. What a banana.
God is our rock, a firm foundation that doesn't get shaken by any storm.
Yeah, that's right, Spoons. Building our lives on him means listening to him. It means doing what he says. Then we will not be shaken, even during tough times like we're going through right now with the coronavirus, you know.
Aye, that's right, Spoons.
That's right, Fruit and Veg.
That God is our rock.
Yeah.
And that he can never, ever be shaken. That helps us to grow, to trust him even more. Because we know we can depend on him. And if we know we can depend on him, we grow to love him even more.
Yeah, we do.
And you know what? We show him that we love him by saying, Holy Spirit, help me to live the way that Jesus lived.
Yeah, live my life your way, Jesus.
Yeah, that's right. It's all coming together, you know.
Why don't we make something together, King's Kids, to remind ourselves that God is our rock?
Oh, yes. What could we make that would remind us that God is our rock?
I know. I made one earlier. Should I get it?
Oh, yeah. Go on then, Strawberry. What did we make earlier? Okay, she's gone down to the cellar.
Here we go.
Oh, she's coming up from the cellar now.
It's been keeping cool. Look
up
at
from
this.
From the depths she arose. She's a mighty triumph for her foes. Oh, hey, look at this wee place.
This is our house on a rock.
Yes, now in Scotland, we call a wee house in the countryside a croft.
Oh.
So you could say, we're going to craft a croft.
Craft a croft. Love it. Right,
no,
I'm going down to the cellar,
that's
Kids
on the rock.
Kids, to get everything you need. Just watch out now.
Now, you can probably see from this some of the things that you're going to need, but Clary, Strawberry, has just gone down to the cellar to get the things we need. Oh, here we go. So first, you need a chopping board or a plate. Next, you'll need a knife. She got that out in the sock. And some bread. And crackers. Aye. We've got plenty of crackers around here. Oh, thank you. Some jam, Strawberry. Thank you. Jam you'll need. And you'll need some cereal. And maybe some more cereal, so you have a bee choice. And spaghetti. Whoa.
I'm coming back. Good
job. She's coming up out of the cellar now. So, chopping board or a plate, a knife, some bread, crackers, some jam, some cereal, and spaghetti. Are you all right, Strawberry? Heck, did you catch your head on the door of the cellar?
I'm having some trouble with my head. Can you help me with my head?
Hold on, King's Kids. Hold on. This can happen from time to time. Having strawberry hair can be a bit tricky. And
it's
a bit sticky. Okay, right. So, while you go and get what you need ready to
do
this.
We're going to do the Highland Fling.
Yes, that's right.
Are you ready?
We're going to fling stuff about in a sort of Scottish way.
Are you ready?
Oh, we need a timer. We need to know how long 1 minute is because you've got one. Thank you, Strawberry. Let me put the timer there. It's on.
Oh,
hold your hand.
Stop finding!
things, kids.
Time is up. It's now time to start building. So we're going to be like the wise builder.
We are.
Who built his house on the rock. Now, this week, King's Kids, Strawberry and I, we are going to be building the house together. Yeah. We're going to do it together. So we're not going to do two, we're going to do one.
Yeah.
At the same time.
Let's start then. Let's get our bread on the chopping board.
Just making sure it's all okay. There we go. Nice. Start with some bread.
Then you take one of your crackers and it's a bit like a shape to cut around. Ben's.
That's right, strawberry. That's right. So you lay your cracker on top of the bread in the middle of the bread. Then you take your knife. Now, you're not going to go all the way through the bread, so you're just going to sort of gently go around the cracker.
It's called scoring, the special name. Scoring the cracker round.
Yes, yeah, so around we go, last side.
Yes.
Now, what you'll find once you've done that, so you're just sort of doing gentle jabs down. You're not really jabbing down really hard like that. You're just gentle.
Yes.
Okay, then you'll find you've got a bit of a square shape. See, it's not come through so much the other side, and then I'm just going to score a wee bit more.
Ooh, very good, Ginger. Very
because
good.
Because these are going to be the trenches.
Ooh.
Ready to put your jam in, because Ooh. We want to build our house firmly fixed to the rock. We don't
yes.
want our house just to be resting on the rock.
No.
We want it to be stuck in the rock.
So this is the next bit. Once you've done your scoring, you're going to take your jam, which is obviously Jesus' love. What else is it today, Ben?
That's right.
What's Ginge. Yeah.
Yes, right. Get the jam into the
scoring bit.
Yeah, that's right. So this is the foundations.
This is the foundations.
Ready for the walls of your house.
Yes.
Now, look, you I'm may just have scoring seen a real house being built.
Look at that, just scoring in the foundations, into those grooves.
If you've seen a real house being built.
Into that groove.
You will know that they start by digging some trenches.
Yes, they do.
And they fill the trenches with concrete rock.
Look at that.
Once they have found rock themselves.
Foundations.
So that the house can be built.
That's
on solid
so
ground.
Good.
Right. Now, next we need some crackers. Four crackers to make our wall. So we've got one. So we need three more. Okay, now are we best adding
this to one edge? Oh, this is the important bit.
Now, so what we're going to do next is we're going to stick our cracker into the foundation of love.
Yes,
the gluey love. But first, before we put that into the ground.
Oh, I'm sorry.
That's all right.
I was just moving it so I could have a dip.
Just jam. Oh, jam one side, like so.
And I'm ready. Doing another side.
Yes, now it's best if you do this first, doesn't it? Because then I'm going to stick that into there like that. Oh, that's really snug. That's great. That's holding well.
Now I've got you one ready, Ginge.
Okay, thank you, Strawberry. Then you're going to stick the end of that one. Let me turn that around so you can see a bit better. Into the jam on the floor and into the up against the jam on the side.
This is really important that you do it this way, isn't
it? Yes. So it's important that the back of your house overlaps the side of your house.
Yes, right. That's so good.
And then we're going to carry on doing that sort of arrangement as we go around. So this side here, the cracker's going to go into the floor, but...
That's really good. Look at that.
The back of it goes up against the side.
So you might need some help while you're doing this, or help. Maybe you help somebody make theirs, and then you help them make theirs.
So the idea is that one overlaps the other, and it makes it stronger as you build your walls.
There's the last piece. It's great.
Oh, right.
Jesus' love is so sticky, isn't it? God's love.
Yes.
So
he wants
good.
His love not to go anywhere.
Oh, that's so brilliant.
He wants it to stay with us.
Now,
thinking, Skids, the next thing we need to do is to make the roof. So you need to get another cracker.
Aye.
And this is great because this time all you're going to do is just spread the love of God all over the top.
I see.
Because then what we're going to do is we're going to get a sprinkle of any cereal you've got available and you're going to make the... What do we call them? The tiles on your roof.
Aye, the shingles or the tiles.
Look, what we do is we sprinkle we sprinkle the tiles on our chopping board and then we just go splat. Just like that. Splat and
just
tap.
Just a splat. Like that. This
splat,
is a great building
and
technique.
Wiggle. And then
a wiggle. Splat and a wiggle.
Just raise it up and there we have the tiles on our roof. Isn't that splendid, boys and girls?
That is a lovely job, Strawberry. That looks beautiful. Now, I am just getting the tops of the walls ready that the roof,
really
which is
good.
What you've just made, can stick to the top. Now, it's a wee bit tricky trying to get jam on the edge of a cracker.
It's tricky.
At the top of your wall, in our case.
Now.
But you were going to do the windows. I might be getting a wee
bit
ahead.
Oh, you are, because, do you know, before you put the roof on, King's Kids, you're going to get some of your cereal that you might have
Strawberry.
That is shaped.
I don't.
What?
Sorry, carry on. Yeah.
Oh, get some cereal that may be shaped like a window. Shredders are perfect, but use whatever you have. You might have a cornflake. You might have, a bran flake.
Yeah.
Whatever you've got, it's going to be your window. And here we go. It's very good, this stuff. You glue on with your jam and you stick and you hold your finger at the back and you press on the front.
That's important, isn't it? Just to stop your cracker from breaking.
Yeah.
All right, I'll stick on that side.
Got a bit covered in
Are you going to make
crispies.
The door, Strawberry?
I'm going to do the door. Are you going to do? Are you going to do the do we call it? The path?
Yes. The doorstep.
The doorstep. I'm going to do the door. Look
so that when people come to visit,
finger at the
they
back.
Don't get their feet in the mud.
Finger at the front. Give it a little squish. That's so lovely.
Oh, that's been beautifully done, Strawberry. Beautiful. Now I'll just add the step in front of your door.
Oh, that's
there we
so
go.
Good.
Then we're ready for the roof.
But before we do the roof, we need to do the chimney, boys and girls. Right, here we go. Now this is where you need some more jam. This is so nice. So you have the base for your chimney to make it strong. And all you're going to do is get a bit of your lovely jam glue and stick it on like that. Then you're going to do again a bit of your jam glue. Take an edge like this and stick it like that. Then you stick it like that. Now, because I've been a bit of a cheat, I haven't put the back on my chimney.
Do you need some jam to stick it on there?
Well, I do. I think I do. Yeah, a bit of jam to stick it on there. And once I've got it on there, I can put the back of my chimney on. Now it's very delicate. Can you see I'm having to wiggle and stick to make sure? Shall we see if it's stuck? Oh, it is. Now we're just going to do the last bit of the back of our chimney.
Back of the chimney.
So that
you can have a nice fire in your house.
Yeah. There, let's just carefully. Oh.
Okay, that was a bit close. Right.
Now.
There we go.
What's next, Jim?
A roof on, Strawberry. Get the roof
on. Which way would you like the chimney? Facing near the front or round near the back?
You decide.
I think we'll go for on the side.
All right, Strawberry.
Let's just carefully place it on like that. We did it!
Well
the house
done.
On the rock!
Nicely placed. Now, round the edge of our little house, we decided to put a wee fence as well. So if you happen to have some spaghetti, what you can do is break it into little fence posts.
Yeah, this
so
is going to be fun.
Maybe just about
just
that long, something like that. Because we've made our rock out of bread, you can just stick it into the bread. And bit by bit, I'll do this side, you can do that side.
Thank you, Ginge. I love this because it just goes in so nicely, doesn't
it? And it finishes just off your house, keeps it protected.
Oh, it's so lovely.
From people and things that may come to attack your house.
Yeah, look at that. I love that.
Yeah, so it's a good strong fence. Yeah, round the edge. But of course, people who you do want to see, they can come to the door.
They can come to the door. Building our life on God, who is our rock. Yes. Listening to him and doing what he says. All with the help of the Holy Spirit. Because we want to live our life his ways, not ours.
That's right, Strawberry, we do.
That's so lovely.
We do. And thankfully, he is our protector.
That is
one of the things that he does. So there's fence all around the outside.
Well, don't forget last week we found out that he is our shepherd.
That's right, we did.
He's so many good things, God.
But this fence around the outside is like protection. And that's what he gives to us too.
Yeah.
He protects us.
He does. He's such a great God.
Thank you, Papa
God. There is no one like you.
There has never, ever been anyone like you. There is
no one like you. There has never, ever been anyone like you.
Right, I think I've got all the fence on this side. How about you?
I think we have. And I just think now, King's Kids, we are just really excited to see how you make your house on the rock, which is God.
Yes, now this is a tricky craft, this one. So take your time.
Take your time.
And don't worry too much if you get jammy fingers as you're making sure the glue sticks everywhere. Because you can always
jammy,
lick your fingers.
Mr. Jam. Shall we go and wash our hands now, Mr. Jam?
Good idea.
Let's go.
What are you doing?
I'm going the special way.
Okay.
Disappearing.
All right.
Steady. Go. Hello, King's Kids.
Hey.
We are
good to
back.
Be back.
Yeah. In the King's Kids kitchen.
In the King's Kids kitchen. Is there something we can eat here, Claire?
Ben, look at these. I can tell that you guys have been creating with ginger and strawberry jam again, haven't you?
Awesome. How have you been getting on?
Now, looking at the house, it's standing on a very solid foundation.
What does it tell you,
Claire? It tells
me,
Ben, that King's Kids have been finding out that God is their rock.
God is our rock. He is solid. He is immovable. He is greater, bigger, stronger than anyone, anywhere. And he promises that when you build on him, nothing is going to knock you over, even if the storm or something is really big trying to do that, like coronavirus, trying to knock you over so that you're like fearful and you just maybe feel like falling apart. Maybe we do feel like that, but God says, look, trust in me.
Stand on me, the rock.
Yes, and I will make you strong.
Yes, let's pray
for
together.
For a long time. Forever, in fact.
I'm going to pray.
Wonderful.
You say it back with Ben. Here we go,
okay.
King's Kids.
Good plan.
Dear God.
Dear God.
Thank you that you are our rock.
Thank you that you are our rock. And you rock.
That can never be shaken.
That can never be shaken.
Help me to live my life trusting you.
Help me to live my life trusting you.
Doing what you say.
Doing what you say.
Amen.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord.
Yes, thank you, Lord, that you are our rock. You are solid. We can depend on you today, the rest of today, tomorrow.
The next day and forever.
Because he never changes.
Yeah. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Totally trustworthy.
Now, I think it's time for you and I to have our daily walk.
Okay, let's go.
Oh, they're so messy. Honestly. Hi, King's Kids. I'm just cleaning up yet again. Still no cooking for Kitchen Caleb. Honestly, I'm just thinking about changing my name legally. Anyway, as you can see, I've laid out the pans to dry. and wiping this down, but seeing as the pan's there, I think it's time that we played the game. So, to play this game, you guys need to grab an assortment of pans, pots, and is that a colander? That's a colander. And you also need to grab, once again, a potato, or a potato, and also a spoon, a wooden spoon, metal spoon, just a spoon. Okay, and you guys have got 20 seconds to go and grab them. Okay, on your marks, get set, go. One potato, two potato, three potato, four, five potato, six potato, seven potato, more, nine potato, 10 potato, 11 potato, 12, 13 potato, 14 potato, 15 potato, 16. This rhyme is rubbish. 17 potato, 18 potato, 19 potatoes, 20 potatoes. Okay, time's up, King's Kids. And now you've got everything.
Oh,
we're gonna, oh, hello.
Kitchen Caleb, what is happening in the kitchen now? We left you here.
Impeccable time.
Tidying up because, you know, there was just a tiny little bit of mess left after Strawberry and I had made another amazing creation. And look what I find, the pots and the pans, they're all here on the floor and they should be in the cupboard. And you've got the spoon out and you've got the potato on the floor. What's going on?
Well, as you can see, this is looking spick and span, as you like to say, lovely and tidy.
And
the pans are out there because I was letting them to dry, because I just washed them after your messy cooking. And now we're going to, well, seeing as they're there, we're going to play a game.
We're going to play a game?
Game.
Well, why didn't you say so, Kitchen Caleb? That changes everything. And by the looks of it, we're going to play Pop the Potato.
Pop the Potato.
Oh, hey, I can see by this. So you need three pans at the back, two in the middle, and then one at the front, because these are where you are going to pop your potato. And the one at the front here, that could win you the most points. Yeah. That's 10 points to get your potato
big,
in
big
here.
Big money.
5 points if you get your potato in the middle pans, and then 3 points if you get it in any at the back. Whoa.
Yeah, so that's this setup over here. And also remember, you need to have somebody behind the pans to be your scorer and to throw the potato back. And now, if you are doing the potato throwing or spooning, then you need to lie down by the potatoes. You need to lie down flat and you need to make a note of where your height is. And then you need to shuffle back. Shuffle back, shuffle, shuffle, shuffle. So you're on the spot.
That's it. So however tall you are your height away from the pans. So Caleb, he's really tall. So that's why he's so far away. Works for social distancing too.
It does work for social. We would normally take it in turns, but you know, we can't. It's too much hassle with social distancing.
Right.
Anyway, and then once you're sat here, get your potato, pop it on your spoon, and get ready to throw it. So,
we're gonna have a tester just to see what happens.
Should we see what happens?
Yes, all right, see how you go. Oh, awesome!
Yes,
Caleb just scored 5 points.
I just potted that potato, yes.
Okay, right.
And that's what you have to say every time you pot one. You have to say, I potted that potato. That's the rule of the game.
It is, it's just the rules, that's all.
Just how it works.
Yeah, you just lose unless you say it.
So, 1 minute.
Yep.
And your minute starts now.
Here it goes. Go on, Caleb. Oh, he was scoring for the 10. Not quite. Didn't quite get it. Oh, he bounced out to the 10 and in the 3. So that's 3 points for Caleb.
That potato.
3 points. Oh, he's got a 10. He went for gold. He's got 13 now. 10 and 3.
Now look. 13.
Oh, yeah.
That potato was
oh, my goodness. That's 23 points.
There you go. Over the shoulder.
Time as well, and 26
points. Oh, close.
Oh, nearly hit my potato. 21 points in total for Caleb in this round of Pop the Potato.
Such a shame. Well, that's a new high score for me, actually, so I'm really happy. And I wonder if any of you can beat that absolutely phenomenal time that I had.
It was good.
Let us know how you got on. Send in your pictures, and it's time for... Home challenges!
Home challenges! Of course it's time for the home challenges.
It is home challenge time.
Which means it's chat about sandwich.
That is our first home challenge, as always.
So as you're having your lunch, or maybe a snack, or your dinner tonight.
Or tea.
Choose to do a chat about sandwich.
Yeah.
So, pray before you start, and then have your Bible ready to do a big word race with your family and see if you can find Isaiah chapter 6, verses 1 to 3.
Ooh, who is going to be the winner of this big word race? It's always good to get to know where different books are in the Bible.
Yeah.
Because then you can find them when maybe you need to find what the Bible says about something that would really help you right now.
Yeah. Now, when you found it, you read it together and you chew it over. What is this telling us?
Ooh, and then there is a big question you can ask for all of you to think of an answer. What did the angels say God is?
Ooh.
What did the angels say God is?
And then have a chat about it.
Yeah.
And after you've chat about it a bit, pray and thank God for helping you understand more of His word.
Yeah, thank you, Lord. You do that.
Now, we have got our blessed list again. I'm wondering how you got on last week when we asked you to pray for the people on your blessed list to know that God is their good shepherd.
Yeah, He always is a good shepherd to all of us. Now, this week, we're going to get our blessed list out again, and we're asking you to pray that the people on your list would come to know God is our rock.
Yes.
Now, as an extra thing, you could, if it came up in conversation, you could pray, Lord, perhaps I could get to talk to one of these people on my blessed list about what makes them feel safe and secure.
Yeah.
And then I could listen to what they say. That would help me to know how to pray for them better.
Yes. So that's what you've got to do with your blessed lists this week. Now, we've only got one thing left to do, and that's find out which 10 children are going to have jammy dodgers getting sent to them in the post.
So I'm going to get mixing straight away. The mixy bowl from the King's Kids Kitchen has got all the names that are left of children yet to have something sent to them in the post. Who's it going to be? Which 10 today? So out it comes on the spoon. First one is Malachi.
Well done, Malachi.
Okay, I'm going in again.
Two.
Number two, we have Joshua.
Well done, Joshua.
Number three is Didier.
Didier. Well done, Didier. Number four
is Divine.
Well done, Divine.
What a lovely name.
The boys are coming out today. Number five.
Number five is a girl. It's Violet.
Well done, Violet. Number six.
Number six is Grace.
Well done, Grace. Number seven
is Glenna.
Well done, Glenna. Number eight.
Number eight is Jorim.
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 Wow. Number nine.
Number nine is James.
Well done, James. Number 10.
Number 10 is Charlotte.
Well done, Charlotte.
Yay.
Wow. Now, those are coming into the post to you.
Yes, they
will. And all we've got left to say is have a wonderful week.
Yes.
We love you and we'll see you next week.
And don't eat your jammy dodgers all at once.
Bye-bye, King's Kids.
We love you.
We love you. Don't forget, God is your rock.
He rocks, God.
Have you heard of the one called Savior? Have you heard of His perfect love? Have you heard of the one in heaven? Have you heard how He gave His Son? 'Cause I have found this love, I believe in the Son. Show me your way, Jesus.
did it.
Can I do it one more time?
Yeah.
Three.
Roughly halfway through the time as well. And 26 spin. Points. Oh, close.
Oh, nearly hit my potatoes.
Let's go, Claire.
This is the worst.